Hi friends, welcome to Offer Studies YouTube channel. This is part 22 in Azure Data Factory real-time scenarios playlist. In this video, we are going to discuss a use case where we want to merge multiple rows into single row using mapping data flow in Azure Data Factory. Along the way, we are going to discuss like how to use the collection function in the mapping data flow. So let me explain you the requirement first. If you see this Excel sheet, let's assume your source file or your source table has a data like this: employee ID, employee name and skill. For example, if you see here, employee ID 1 has a skills like C sharp and ADF, and employee 2 has a skills SQL and Databricks, and employee 3 has skills Python and Azure ML. So if you have your source data like this, then finally what you want in your sync location, you want data to be appear like this. For each employee, all the skills what he or she has, it should be appended with the commas like this as a single string. So if you technically speak, I am trying to merge these two rows, line number 2 and line number 5, these two rows as a single row, right? And also if you see these two rows, I am trying to merge as a single row. So we are basically merging multiple rows into single row. So this is what the requirement. Let's see how to achieve this. So if I show you this file, I have already created a file for that. And if you see here, employee skills.csv file in my blob storage, this file contains exactly same data. Let me practically show you the data as well here. When I click this edit button, here I can see my data as well, right? You can see here employee ID, employee name and skill, and everything is properly there. Okay, so this is fine. Now let me go to my Azure Data Factory. So as I said, I have to do this implementation using data flow. There is no other way to do it. Any transformed data, if you want to achieve in the Azure Data Factory, then you have to go with the data flows only. So let's add a source here for our data flow first, and this is going to be my employee skills file. So I have this file in my blob storage, so let me create a new data set for it. Blob storage, let me click continue. It is a CSV format. Continue, and let me name this as DS, that means dataset_employee_skill. Okay, now so let me select my link service here. It's going to be blob storage. Let me browse a location. So I have my file under ADF demo container, data folder, and it is inside employee skills. So this is the file, employee skills.csv file. So let me select this first row as a header and let me click OK. So I created a data set for my file now, and I have selected the data set here. If I go to projection here, I can see my columns are coming properly already, and even I can do the data preview as well to see whether data is coming here properly or not. To preview your data in the data flows, you need to make sure to enable this data flow debug option. Okay, so let's wait for the preview to load here. Great, we can see our data is available here, right? The same data whatever I have shown in the Excel sheet, the same data is now available for us in the source. So now how we can do this merging, how we can merge this multiple rows. So for that, what you can do, you can use a aggregate transformation. And in the aggregate, so again, what is aggregate transformation, source transformation, everything I have explained in my Azure Data Factory playlist, so please watch there. So in the aggregate transformation, what I am going to do, I am going to do a group by employee ID, and I am going to apply some function called collection on top of this column, so that these column values will get merged as a single rows. So what I am going to do, under aggregates here, I am going to select my column skills column, and here I am going to add an expression using a collection function. So what this collect function will do, actually it will take multiple values from multiple rows into a single row by making it as an array. So you can read it collects all the values, aggregate them into an array. So that is what it will do. So when I apply this collect of skill, what it is going to do, it will actually group by employee ID, that means 1 1, and whatever the values you have for the skill C sharp and ADF, it is going to take all these values into a collection, like array collection. Okay, so let's click this save and finish. And now if I see the inspect tab for this aggregate transformation, I am only getting employee ID and skill. Why I am not getting employee name? Because if you see this aggregate settings, and if I go to group by, here I am grouping by only employee ID, and in the aggregates I am computing a column called skill, but nowhere I haven't selected the employee name. So that is the reason it is not showing any employee name column under this output schema. So what I should do here, let me click this plus sign here to add another column under this group by, and I am going to select a employee name here. That means I am going to group by employee ID and name and performing a collect function on top of my skill column. Okay, so now if I go to data preview and if I try to refresh, you are going to see the data as expected. So you are going to see all these skill values in a array format. Okay, so let me practically show you that here. Let's wait for the data preview to load here. Great, you can see now we are getting only 3 employees, employee ID 1, 2, 3. And if you see the skills for each employee, when I click it here, see, for employee ID 1, it is C# and ADF. Similarly, if I see for employee ID 2, it is SQL and Databricks, right? So, but this is not our desired output. Here we are getting skill column as an array. Okay, but our desired output is something like this. All the skills should be comma separated values. So how to get that? How to get this entire thing into this comma separated string? So to do that, what I'm going to do, I am going to use a derived column expression. And in the derived column expression, I am going to select my skill column. Okay, and let me open expression builder to write an expression here. So here, for this skill column, what I am going to do, I am going to use a toString function. And in the toString function, I am going to pass my skill array. So skill is the column name which contains your array, right? You can see here this array symbol as well here. So if I do this, what will happen? The entire array will get converted into string. Let me click this save and finish. And let me go to data preview and let me refresh this here and show you the results. Great. See, now my skill column is a string type. You can see this ABC small notation. That means it's a string. But my string contains double quotes, open bracket and close bracket and everything, right? So what I should do, I should try to replace this entire double quotes and this angular bracket open, angular bracket close. I have to replace everything with blanks. Then only I can actually get like this C# comma ADF. So right, I should replace this double quotes and also I should replace this open bracket and close bracket. So let's do that as well. So let me go to this derived column transformation settings, open this expression builder here, and here whatever the output I am getting from this toString, what I want to do, okay, let me click cancel here. Let me open my expression builder once again. So here, let me use a replace function, and in the replace function, whatever the toString value, that means this entire value I am passing to the replace function, and now I am going to tell to the system replace replace wherever you see open bracket, replace that with empty. Okay, so now what this will do, this is going to replace this open bracket. Now what I have to do, I have to replace this close bracket as well. So now what I am going to do, on top of this entire output, I am going to use this replace function once again, and this time I am going to replace close angular bracket with empty. Okay, so now this time what it is going to do, it is going to replace this close bracket as well. Now what I left, I need to replace this double quotes as well. So what I am going to do, I am going to use another replace function on top of this entire thing, and this time I am going to say to replace these double quotes, okay, replace these double quotes with empty. Okay, so now what I can do, I can click this save and finish, and now if I try to data preview, actually this time my output is going to be exactly similar to this thing, C# comma ADF, SQL comma Databricks and all. So let's see that output here. Great, you can see now my skill column contains all my skills with comma separated values. So that means indirectly we merged all these multiple rows into single row. Okay, so now what I can do, on top of this output, I can use a sync transformation to load this data into some table or some file. So what I am going to do in my case, I want to load this file into blob storage into some folder. So let me use CSV format here, and let me say this data set name like ds_output. So let me use a linked service, let me browse a location. So ADF, under ADF demo container, maybe I want to create an output folder, and in that folder I want to load this. So what I am going to do, I am going to type my folder name here, hard-coded values, and there is no schema because it, right now we don't have any file. Click OK, and here if I go to sync transformation settings, I want this file name to be saved as a single file, and the file name should be like maybe emp skills output.csv, like that. emp_spills_output.csv. Let's click this set single partition. So that's it. Okay. So now if I execute this entire data flow, right, automatically I am going to get my file generated in the blob storage output folder with my desired output as per this Excel sheet, whatever the output. So let me practically show you that by running this one as well. So let me create a new pipeline here. And in this new pipeline, I want to execute this data flow one here. Let me drag and drop and paste it here. Let me go to here, data flow one. You can let me go to this pipeline 3 here. Let me debug execute my pipeline here to get the output in my file. So let's wait for the execution to kick off here. Whenever you run your pipeline in a debug mode, all your pipeline executions will actually appear under this output tab. So I just initiated the debug execution. Let's wait for the execution to appear here. Great, our pipeline, you can see our data flow is currently in progress. So it will take around 1 or 2 minutes to complete this execution. So let's wait and then I will show you the output file as well. Great, our pipeline execution is successfully completed here. If I go back to my blob storage, if I go back to ADF demo container, I can see an output folder here, and also you can see my file also get generated. If I open this file, I can see my data as well there. So if I click this edit here to view the data, you can see employee ID, name and skill. You can see 3 employee details. And also if you see these skills, why these skills came in a double quotes? Because this entire thing is a single column, right? In CSV, usually comma means next column, right? But here, this entire string is a single column for the skill column, right? So whatever the values you have with the commas, those values will be added with the double quotes automatically from the system. Okay, so don't worry about the double quotes. So hope this given a clear idea like how we implemented like merging multiple rows into single row using data factory and collection function. So I hope you guys enjoyed this demo. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notifications whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.